14 minutes before 12 o'clock, we're going to have fun with Dan. It's normally called Fun with Joe, but Joe's not here today. And there he is. Yay! Here he comes. He's coming into the room now. Dan Martone taking a seat next to Robin. Yay! Ready to challenge Robin to another fun episode of Name That Tune.
I could just sit here and be quiet. They would have no idea.
No, we make have to make silly. A big deal out of it. Everything, it's show business. It's all showy. Everything is showy about what we do.
I'll just sit here and be quiet.
Yesterday.
What did you say? Makes great radio.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I just sit here and be quiet.
Oh, yeah, we had a show like that before. The one-word answer guy?
Yeah. Yes.
I would ask a question. I would try to formulate a question that would require large numbers of words to answer. Mm-hmm. And he would say yes.
Exactly. Yes. Not even yes, Larry. Just yes.
Yes.
So how do you do this? Yes.
All right. Now, yesterday in the game, I brought to this show songs that were all from Guy Lombardo because we were approaching New Year's and Guy Lombardo was synonymous with New Year's Eve once upon a time.
He was, yeah.
And unfortunately for you and Robin, they were all songs kind of before your time, especially you, Dan. I think Robin had a little bit of an edge. She remembered some of them.
I'm older.
A little bit older. A lot older.
I could be your mom.
Oh, no, I wouldn't push it. Let's not go there.
All right. So anyway. Today, it's the exact opposite. It's newer songs. I think maybe the earliest song I have on here is from... Well, I think I have one from the 70s, but the rest are either 80s, 90s, or most of them are like 2000s.
Oh, my.
Okay?
This is going to be hard, too, actually.
So, well, you were in the same boat. You're both in the same boat.
Yep. There you go.
Now, you do have a lifeline in the office today. Your daughter is here.
Yep.
And how old is she?
She's 16.
So she might know some of these.
She probably does.
But it's up to her who she gives the answer to.
Lisa.
All right, today,
she knows who she's going home with.
Today the prize is a $25 gift certificate to the Ale House, and you will win it if you bet on the winner. And so I need somebody to bet on Robin and somebody to bet on Dan, and we'll take your call off the air. The phone number you'll need to call is the WOCA Climate Control Source Hotline, which is 352 if you're out of the area. Mm-hmm. And then 622-9622. We'll be right back.
They've served our country. They've kept us free, and they need your help.
We're sitting in Veterans Park. You can't sit here not realizing that you're surrounded by heroes. There are a lot of heroes in our community. A lot of heroes, unfortunately, are not in good financial shape. They're hurting both physically and financially. We step in and help directly. Our role is to reach out to them. We're there to help the veteran. We do counseling. We do outreach. Sometimes it's just coming into the office and sitting down and saying, hey, I've got a problem, and you're talking to another veteran who understands that problem.
Everybody who works for the Vets Helping Vets are awesome, and they are so kind to everybody. They're like my second family. They really are.
They have been there during the holidays. I have gotten unexpected visits, assistance.
Vets Helping Vets of Marion County needs your help. Call today, 352-433-2320, and pledge your support to Vets Helping Vets of Marion County.
It really has been a blessing.
The Festival of Lights at Silver Springs, with more than a million twinkling lights and one holiday delight after another. Experience real snow on the Snow Toboggan Express. Warm up to Miss Molly's spellbinding stories. Catch the Victorian sounds of the Dickens carolers. And listen for the reindeer bells announcing the arrival of Santa Claus and his Silver River sleigh. Bring your camera, because Santa makes time for photo ops with the kids from 5 to 8 p.m. Then stay for the fantastic fireworks finale. The Festival of Lights is yours with an all-access platinum pass for as little as $51.99. Get unlimited admission to Silver Springs for a full year, including live concerts, special events, and VIP seating. All for $51.99. The Festival of Lights, December 14th through the 31st. For showtimes, visit silversprings.com.
We have our players. How come I don't hear myself? There you go.
I can hear you.
10 minutes before noon. Melissa is betting on Dan.
Yay!
Did Melissa bet on you yesterday, Robin?
I don't recall.
Okay. And she gave up on you. She said, forget Robin. I'm going to go with Dan.
Yeah.
And Jay is betting on Robin. Jay is betting on you, Robin. All right. Ready?
All right. What are we playing?
This is the game. The same game. It's called Ring the Bell. Ring My Bell. Whatever we call it. It's we changed the name to Fun with Joe, but it's really Ring the Bell.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you ring the bell, if you know the answer. Because whoever rings the bell first gets to answer the question first.
Are we afraid to call it Ring My Bell because of the song?
I don't know. I don't Ring My Bell. Well, no, because it's really not my bell.
It's my bell, though.
That's right. Dan has one of his very
own. All right, here we go. Here's today it's all relatively new songs. Hold on. And Alyssa, if you can hear it, we might need your help here. All right, here's the first one. Where did I put it? Here it is.
Okay.
27 is what it's called.
Ah.
Oh, okay. Well, I got it then. 27.
Here we go. Wait a minute. That sounds like...
Sounds pretty old. Sounds like... Oh, wait. That's... It's old anxiety.
Wait a minute.
Wow.
All right.
We playing a different game? We're going to go to commercial break, and we'll be right back.
Wait a minute. Let me see if this one is right. How did I get that one wrong? All right, here's another one. See if this one is right. There you go.
Britney Spears.
Britney Spears, very good.
Ooh, okay, Dan gets up, Dan, and wants to get a point.
What's the song called?
Yes, it is.
whoa, bop, bop, bop. No.
Something fire. Something about the DJ?
I don't know if that's in the words or not, but that's not the title, no.
Okay. Watch me move when I lose, when I lose control?
No.
Oh, I can't remember the name of this.
Watch me move?
No. Get you off with the touch, dancing in
the dark. You notice what I'm wearing, I notice when you're staring. Yeah, I like the song, but I don't know what the name of it is. I got no clue.
No idea, huh?
Call in, Jay.
Anybody?
All right, nobody seems to know.
All right, can't take it no more?
You got a point because you got Britney Spears down. That's not the title. It's called Till the World Ends.
Oh, right. I knew that.
Till the World Ends.
Okay.
As soon as you said it, I remembered it.
Till the World Ends.
Well, Melissa's on the board with one. Jay, we have zips over.
All right, here's another one. This one is not as new as that one, I don't think. And here it is.
Aerosmith.
Yeah, very good.
Wow.
Very good. You got 2 points.
Wow.
There's you can get another point. There's another artist.
Run DMC.
You got him. Wow.
Wow.
3 points.
4 for Melissa.
Very good.
For me and
you
Jay.
Knew it just from the drum, huh?
Yeah. That was pretty innovative in its day. That was when rock met rap.
Right.
And so that was a pretty new song, pretty new thing for its day when Aerosmith and Run DMC collaborated on this.
Oh, wow.
So now, when was that? The 80s?
Yeah, probably 87. Something like that.
All right.
And wasn't this in the new Alice movie with Johnny Depp? The Cheshire Cat sang this one?
Oh, might have, yeah. I don't remember that part.
Yeah. That movie?
Oh,
that
really?
One,
but really?
I don't remember.
All right, here's another one. Who is this and what's it called?
Okay.
Wow, that's new agey, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a trip. It's an acid trip. And this is playing where? When?
I think this
Boys
is...
to Men?
No.
Huh. Rap group? Is it a group?
I can't take anymore.
I don't know if it's a group or an artist. The name is confusing.
Oh, well, that makes it easier then. Oh, confusing.
The name is two initials, if that helps.
Not really. RJ?
That's one of the initials.
Which one? RJ?
One of them.
RK?
J-Lo. No.
No.
That's three letters.
That's right.
All right, nope.
R4.
Nobody knows that one either, huh? These are all songs that could be played this coming Monday night. These are all on the lineup for, what's the guy's name again?
Oh, yes, not Dick Clark's guy. Dick Clark's replacement.
What's his name again?
Ryan Seacrest.
Anyway, yeah. That's a song called Still. It's by an artist named JJ.
Well, we have our own JJ.
He's sung it. That's
right. Go JJ.
Maybe he moonlights.
I didn't know he had his own artistry.
There you go.
That's pretty awesome.
All right, here's another one. See if you know this one.
That's Chumbawamba.
Wow, very good.
Wow.
And what's the song called?
Tub Thumping.
Tub Thumping is right.
Wow.
Very good. Wow.
The music matters.
Compared to how people matter.
There's the chorus everybody knows.
See, this is what I know.
Yeah, yeah, right?
This is where it comes in.
You won money with this one.
I did.
He did.
Wait, you won money?
Yeah, he did.
Okay. $500.
How did you do that?
I don't remember.
Wait. You won. I don't. Yeah, that means he doesn't want to tell us.
No. I'll tell you what I remember.
Okay.
I won $500 from what's that station out of Orlando?
Mix, I think.
Mix 105.1.
106.7.
Doc and Johnny was on.
What, 106.7?
106.7. When Alex was little, we used to listen to 106.7 all the time.
Okay.
And that song came on, and it was some kind of a question.
XL 106.7.
And I called him up and answered the question, and I got it right.
Yeah.
And it was this song.
And they asked me, because I said I was calling from Ocala, and they asked me if we had any malls in Ocala. And I thought, they said, do I have any moles? And I said, well, my dad has one in his backyard. Because he did at that time. Do you remember?
Yeah, I remember that.
And they would say, what do you mean your dad has a mole in his backyard? I said, well, he's leaving little dirt piles. And then they said, we didn't say moles.
But you did.
And you got $500 for that.
I got $500.
Well, yeah, for $500, I'm driving to Orlando, too.
That's right.
I had to go down to the station to pick up the money.
Yeah, you did.
And I was so disappointed that I said, this is all you are? Just this little thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, they have a little office in the building over there.
It was a little tiny office.
I know, I've been there, yeah. You go up the elevator and then...
No, there was no elevator. It was like going into a little storefront, convenience store.
Oh.
There they were.
Yeah.
That's okay. That's why we're going to move into the mall.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Who's this and what's it called?
It's Gwen Stefani.
It is Gwen Stefani.
Oh, wow.
Wow, very good.
Boy. And the shh. So that's what gives me at the bleachers, no principal. It's not bananas, so. Both of us want to be the
winner, but there can only be one. Call in, Jane.
Oh, Hollerback.
Hollerback is right.
Yay.
Hollerback Girls, the total.
8 for Melissa, nothing for me and Jay. Call in, Jane.
Wow.
Sorry.
And you thought you were going to do bad on this one, Dan.
Well, these aren't brand new. These are at least a few years old. I've had time to catch up.
Well,
on the radio.
Hold on now. But these are all on the playlist for, what's his name again?
Ryan Seacrest.
Ryan Seacrest. Yes.
Ryan Seacrest, yes. Yeah.
Ryan Seacrest.
So Ryan Seacrest. So these are the best of.
Don't ask me how it works out, because some of these people aren't around anymore, right?
No, they are, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, Gwen Stefani does the commercial now for the
okay.
For the phone, I think, for the Windows phone.
Here's another. This was kind of a slower one, but it's on the list.
Oh, that's because she's a brand new artist. She did,
I know this song.
I know this song. Stella? No, that's not her name.
Oh, that's close.
Very yeah.
Close.
Adele.
Adele is right, yeah.
Jeez.
And what's her song?
She has an incredible, I have no clue.
She's wonderful.
She has an incredible one?
She, a voice.
Oh.
Didn't she do the James
incredible
Bond
pair
movie?
Of voices, vocal cords. What?
Didn't she sing the song in the new James Bond movie? Wasn't it Adele?
I think you're right, yeah.
Yeah.
I remember hearing the...
Somebody knows it, no?
Call in, Jay. Name of the
song.
Nobody
knows the name.
Come on, you know what that's called?
No, I don't, but this is WOCA Ocala.
Oh!
Yay!
You're 15 seconds early.
Thank you. That's good. No, that's good.
That's good. Okay.
Thank you.
I don't know the name
kind
of the
sad song. That's called Someone Like You.
Someone Like
that's
You.
That's it.
Someone Like You.
Adele. Yeah, she sings incredible, though.
This might be the oldest song
she's
on
impressive.
The list. This might be the oldest song. Robin, you better get this one.
Oh, shake your booty.
Shake your booty!
And that's the guys, the flashy guys.
Dan knows that I can see this phrase.
Flashy guys.
I can't think of his name. You go, Dan. I
thought his mom was in the Papas.
No, you didn't. Did you really?
No, I don't know who it is.
Yeah, you did.
Oh, it's Casey and the Sunshine
Casey
Band.
Casey and the Sunshine Band. You got it.
We got 2 pity points, Jay. Yes, we do. We got 2 pity points.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's a good one, though. That's an all-time favorite of a lot of things.
All right, Dan, I have a feeling you're going to say the title of this next one before I can put the mark next to the song so I know that I've already played it. Here it comes. Let's see if I'm right. Here we go. Here we go. Let's try it right now.
Tone Loc.
Yep. Holy mackerel. All right. Tone Loc is right. What's the song called?
I don't know. Some kind of funky something or other. Some, I don't know. Something.
That's one of the words. Funky.
Yeah. Funky Cole Medina.
Oh, you know it already.
There
wow.
You go.
Wow.
You got it.
This is a real cool song. And this is going to go be the New Year's Eve party, huh?
What's that?
Basically, don't drink too much is what they're saying.
Really?
Be careful what you're drinking.
Oh, what a good positive song.
Oh, yeah. It's great.
Yeah. Well, see, my kids are smart because when they go out, you know, in any time and they know they're going to be drinking, one of them is the designated driver, and then they switch off. So
taxi cab driver, really, that's safe. Our designated driver.
Oh, yeah, they have those, too. Yeah,
those are best ones.
That's right. All right, here's another one. Who's this and what's it called?
Nicki Minaj?
What?
Nicki Minaj?
No.
Is that Lady Gaga?
No.
Catch me at the border.
No, no.
Kesha?
No, no.
How old is this?
I think it's brand new. I don't know.
Oh.
Sounds like 99 Lost Balloons, girl.
It sure does, doesn't it?
Doesn't it? Yeah. Some German artist.
It sure does. It really does, yeah. That's a group called M.I.A.
Okay. Oh, okay.
And the song is called Paper Planes.
Paper Planes.
Okay.
Paper Planes.
That fits with 29 Lost Balloons.
I
got some
of those for Christmas.
The next one I've never heard before, yeah. But I never
missed. Oh, I bet that was fun.
I always know this guy's voice, so I would get this one just from the voice. I'm your score.
Someone is holding. Is that Joe Cocker?
No, no, no. It's a good guess.
This is. It felt like
four. Oh. Leonard Cohen.
No. Oh, good guess.
Sorry, I'm done.
Is he drunk?
No. It could be. I don't know. This is the way he always sounds.
Oh, this is on purpose?
That's how he sings. Every song he sings is.
Oh, Bob Dylan.
We got a call.
Third one. I'm done.
No. Whoa, good morning. You know who that is or what that's called?
Is that Tom Waits?
It is Tom Waits, yes. Who do you want to give the point to?
I want to give that to poor, pitiful Robin.
Oh, thank you so much.
I don't think Tom waited for anybody. He went ahead and started drinking himself.
Thank you, Pete. The song is called New Year's Eve, just so you know.
Is that what it's called?
Okay.
Yeah.
I think he got a head start on it.
Here we go. What's this one called?
Oh, Ice Baby.
Ice Baby. Good, Robin.
All right, very good.
Okay.
Who's the artist? Who's the artist?
Oh, that's, Ice, Baby. Oh, I can't think of his name.
His name's in the title. You can do it. Come on. Pull it out.
Ice.
That's close. You're missing a word.
Ice.
No.
Ice,
no. Before ice. You don't like chocolate. You like
vanilla ice.
There you go.
Yay, we've now got five. And Melissa and Dan have 11.
Oh, no.
That's it. He was here in town, right?
What?
Vanilla Ice? Wasn't here about a year and a half ago?
Something rings a bell.
Performing?
Or was that the fake promoter guy that got in trouble? I think it was the fake promoter who didn't really have him scheduled.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, remember that guy?
You said you had Vanilla Ice and you didn't bring him.
I believe that we had a guy like that doing that. Right. Here's another one.
Yeah, okay.
Rolling Stones?
Rolling Stones is right.
Grown Man Cry?
No.
Early 70s?
Probably, yeah. I don't know. Or maybe even later than that.
Can't think of the name of the song.
I mean, earlier than that. All right, do you know what that's called?
Start Me Up.
Start Me Up is right.
Yay!
Who's the point for?
For Miss Robin, please.
Oh,
Robin!
We're catching up, Jay. We got Melissa and Dan at 12.
All right, let me see if I get
that's
one.
That's a good one, yeah. Start Me Up. That's a good New Year's Eve song, actually.
Let's
see if I get one more in there.
No, okay,
here
one
we
more.
Go. One more. Any idea?
No.
David Bowie?
No. Who's the winner, Robin?
Oh, Melissa wins, and I apologize, Jay. So sorry. But Melissa, come down, pick up your prize.
This is the group that your dad loves, the name of Death Cab for Cutie. Death Cab for Cutie. The song is called The New Year.
Woo!
Hang in there. Mike Huckabee's up next.
Thank you, Larry.
It's The Mike Huckabee Show with our special guest host, J.D. Hayworth.
Wherever you are, whatever you are doing, thank you so much for spending some of your valuable time with me. So here we are, 2 days after Christmas, December 27th, and often what happens, since so many people take this week between Christmas and New Year's off, they start to lose perspective on which days are weekdays and which days are weekends. You ever notice that? It's as if your mind plays a little trick on you that way. But fear not. Here we are hard at work, and I am honored to be behind this microphone for our friend Mike Huckabee. So I am reliably informed that today is Thursday. It may not seem like it to you, but 2 days after Christmas, which fell on Tuesday, today is in fact Thursday. And, you know, we talk about long weekends, but to have the week off with the kids and with relatives and, well, just to have the time, I know many of you are loving that, as I'm sure Governor Huckabee is as well. One guy who cut short his vacation, and I'm sure that so many anchors on at least two of the three primary cable networks providing news and information, I'm sure they are speaking in reverential, if not virtually sacrificial tones about the fact that our president was forced to get on board that custom-fitted 747 known as Air Force One and fly back from Hawaii. And what a tremendous sacrifice on behalf of the American people. And we should just applaud and admire such sacrifice for all of us. Well, a couple of points. Number one, Air Force One is a pretty cool plane. It goes with the perks of the job. I had the honor as a member of Congress on two occasions to accompany then President George W. Bush to my home state of Arizona. And it is a neat plane. And maybe we'll talk about adventures aboard Air Force One later. So the perks involve that fancy airplane that you and I are paying for. And the other point is this. And I know it's tough for so many in the press corps and in Hollywood to believe. But you see, the president, whomever the president is supposed to be working for us and for us, however you want to emphasize that line, ditto members of Congress. And as I understand it, the way it's working now, rather than call back the House, members of Congress have been put on a 48-hour notice when they will be needed back. The Senate is back in business. The president heading back to Washington. And so we go back to the quote, drama of this fiscal situation. Now, yesterday, I made kind of a premature New Year's resolution that I was going to abandon the shorthand utilized by so many in the media to describe our fiscal situation. Please don't misunderstand. It's not that it's not important. It's just that it is such an oversimplification of what we are confronting that to use that term reminiscent of the geographical or topographical precipice upon which Wile E. Coyote often falls off of or steps off of in those memorable Chuck Jones directed and produced Looney Tunes cartoons is to, in some ways, trivialize what's at stake. Now, I'm sure there are those, when they hit upon the phraseology, who said, oh, this really explains it. No, not entirely. So fear not, I am not succumbing to the wiles of the left when there are those on the left who go, gee, it's really not a precipice, it's more of an incline. And those who are just bound and determined to keep on spending anyway. In fact, to be candid about it, our aforementioned president might fall, well, does fall, let's just be honest about it, does fall into that category. How else can you explain the rather disturbing mathematics that enables us to realize that one president in one term has racked